I'm your friend, Wing Commander Santosh Sharma from Bangalore. In the last video, we were talking about Hanuman Chalisa and the Doha. We understood in that video what are the prerequisites and terms and conditions to reap the benefit of Hanuman Chalisa and how to read it. What are the preparation? What are the groundwork that you have to do before reading the Hanuman Chalisa like a parrot? Normally people read Hanuman Chalisa like a parrot every day. Their mind wandering at all the places around and just rattling out without understanding the true meaning of Hanuman Chalisa. As we discussed yesterday, the precondition and the terms and conditions are given in the first Doha. To recapitulate, Sri Guru Charana Saroja Raja Nijamana Mukula Sudhar. With the help of the dust on the lotus feet of your Guru, by His grace, first you remove the dirt and garbage of so-called knowledge from the mirror of your mind, which you have accumulated since your childhood. The knowledge which you have acquired is of no significance at all, because the knowledge which you understand as knowledge is not knowledge, because that is not your experience. Unless you experience something yourself, realize something yourself, it can never become jnana. Knowledge is about information, collection of information. You can know a lot about soul, God, divinity, spiritualism, bliss, love, many, many things. You can learn about all these things because the books are available at very cheap rates, and things are there in the Google. In the olden days, the jnana was to be given from the guru to the disciple by saying and by listening and making the disciple understand, realize and experience those jnanas through his own life. Now what has happened? Hanuman Chalisa is available everywhere. You can buy it for 1 rupee somewhere. People gift it also. Now it has become so cheaply available that people think that it is like the way it is available, Hanuman Chalisa also is like that only. No, it is not that. Hanuman Chalisa is a very powerful compilation of jnana. But you have to understand first the terms and conditions in the beginning. Removing the dirt from the mirror of your mind with the grace of God and welcoming the glory of people like Raghuvara or enlightened soul. Baranau Raghuvara Bhimanajasa Jo Dayak Phalcha. We also understood about the four fruits which you will achieve, that is Kama, that and Artha, Dharma and Moksha. We also talked about Dharma not as religion and Moksha as a liberation, which is a speciality of Hindu Darshana. If you have not watched my earlier video, please do that to understand these things which I am talking to you now. That will help you to have a good grounding to understand Hanuman Chalisa. Now, let's understand the next lines. Buddhihin tanu janike sumiro pavan kumar bal buddhi vidya dehu mohe harahu klesh vikar. It says, first you have to understand that you have no intellect, you have no intelligence. What he's talking about is your egolessness. We are not saying, nobody is saying that you are a duffer or you have no intelligence. But the intelligence which you think is intelligence is not intelligence, in the sense that there is no realization. You are not a realized soul. You are not experienced anything. Talking about God does not make you a person who is God realized. Talking about swimming, talking about flying does not make you a swimmer or a pilot for that matter. So first, surrender your ego बुद्धिहीन तनु जानी के, नो योर सेल्फ एज ए पर्सन हु हैज नो नॉलेज, दैट विल ब्रेक डाउन ऑल योर इगोस. व्हाट इज दैट एक्चुअली यू नो, व्हाट यू थिंक दैट यू नो, इट इज नॉट नोन टू यू पर्सनली. यू हर्ड अबाउट इट, यू रेड अबाउट इट, इट इज नॉट एन एक्सपीरियंस. दैट इज व्हाई सरेंडरिंग योर ईगो, लाइक अ सरेंडर योर सेल्फ टू द गुरु, एज वी आर डिस्कसिंग इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो, सरेंडरिंग योर ईगो फर्स्ट इज द टर्म एंड कंडीशन, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन. सरेंडरिंग बुद्धिहीन तनु जाने के सुमिरो पवन कुमार. रिमेंबर पवन कुमार मीन्स द सन ऑफ द विंड, दैट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द हनुमान. What is Sumiro? Sumiran is what? Remembering? What kind of remembering we are talking about? Because the Sumiran word is used in many scriptures and especially in the Sikhism. Guru Nanak's, Guruvani, etc. In that Sumiran is given a lot of importance. What is basically Sumiran? Sumiro is talking about Sumiro. So what is Sumiran, by the way? It is just remembering when you are doing some kind of puja, or you are meditating, or you are reading Hanuman Chalisa that time. Is that Sumiran? Please understand this in little minor detail so that things will become more clear to you. You see, Sumiran, I'll give an example. Now the mother of a small newborn child is sleeping with her child in the night, deep sleep. She may be very tired and just she's sleeping next to the baby. Now, at midnight, at some other time in the night, the child wakes up, you know, he turns left, right, does some any kind of movement, the small child. Immediately, the mother will get up. The child may be playing somewhere in a room, sitting on a bed or some other place. Mother may be working in the kitchen. But if anything happens to the child, a small sound from the child also draws the attention of the mother. There may be TV sounds, there may be music sounds all around. Nobody might have received and understood the noise made by the small child, but the mother immediately receives this information. What happens? It is because the mother is 24 hours connected with the small baby. Mentally, from the heart, from the mind, in totality. There is a connection between the mother and the child which is uninterrupted. Always it is there. So anything happens to the child at any time, the mother is able to feel. Even if the child grows up and goes somewhere else, it is the mother's heart which knows if the child is not well. She says, I feel that my child has some kind of issues and problems. Have you observed this? Your mother knows you the best. She understands you the best. So the connection between a mother and a child, that continuous connection between the mother and child, and the child being inside the mother, always knowingly, unknowingly, the child is a part of the mother. So you have to become like a mother. You have to have a mother's heart. Like a mother responds to the child, when like the mother always remains connected with the small baby at a subconscious level. Similarly, there has to be a connection between you and your beloved Lord, God. If you love Jesus, fine. If you love Muhammad, it's okay. It's fine. If you love Buddha or Jain or any other spiritual soul, Krishna is fine. Rama is fine. But here we are talking about the mental orientation and conditioning of the mind to become eligible to read Hanuman Chalisa. So we are training our mind to Sumir, keep remembering at a subconscious level to Hanuman. Once we know how to get connected to Hanuman, we can get connected to any divine energy, divine force. It's just a training. Ek sadhe, sab sadhe. If you learn how to master one, you can master others. You learn how to sing a song properly, you can learn sing other songs also properly. If you learn how to drive a scooter or a bike, then you can drive other models of bike also. So learn to reprogram your mind by surrendering and creating that continuous bond and connection with Hanuman, whether you are asleep or you are awake all the time. Your mind should be connected to that divine energy. Pavana Kumar, Hanuman we are talking about. So that is Sumiran basically. That 24-hour connection knowingly, unknowingly. That is bhakti. That is puja. That is aradhana. That is surrendering. You know? Like you're in love with someone. You know? How your mind gets trapped in the thoughts of that person. Have you heard a story about one girl and King Akbar? In Akbar Nama, Akbar has got this narration maid. Once he had gone to a jungle and he was praying, he was doing ibadat to Allah. He has spread something on the ground and he was doing ibadat to Allah, the God, Supreme God. Now suddenly what happened? When he has closed his eyes and praying to Allah, one girl came and dashed against him, toppled over him and ran away. The King Akbar, who was emperor, he opened his eyes and he was very angry. He called that girl back. Come here. Do you know me? I am the emperor. I am the king. And I am praying to Allah. How dare you come and dance against me and run away from here? Are you a mad girl? First of all, look at my dress. Look at my surrounding. You should be able to guess that I am a king. And a king is praying to Allah. And you have the audacity to come and behave like this? You have eyes? Can't you see? The girl told, "Forgive me, dear king. But I was not in my senses. I was rushing past. I was in a great hurry. Because I was going to meet my lover, who is waiting in the other part of the jungle. My lover is in my heart and my soul, and I cannot see anything else. I am unable to see anything else except my lover. That is why perhaps I could not see you, and I dashed against you. But I want to ask one question to you with your kind permission." The emperor told, "Okay, what is your question?" She told, "I am in love with a man, human being, and his love has made me a blind, and I am oblivious of the surrounding, and I am not able to see anybody around me. But you are praying to God, the supreme love, when you are praying to God, how is it that you are able to understand that somebody came and danced against you or toppled over you? Were you really praying to God? Do you really love God? She asked. And the king and the emperor Akbar was taken awake. And he had a self-realization about his state of prayer, the depth of his prayer, the meaning of the prayer, the connection between his soul and the divine soul. He could understand that. He still has ego. And while praying also, he is aware that he is praying. Because prayer is not the ritualistic thing which you do. Doing namaz in a way, Hindu way of praying, something else, other religions, they pray their way. No. Prayers have got nothing to do with rituals. It is basically the state of mind, Sumiran. Sumiran is the word, it's a beautiful word. Sumiran is continuous connection with the divinity and the spiritual force. Do you understand what Sumiran is now? So, it says Sumiran Pavan Kumar. And if you do this, what will happen to you? He says, Bal, Buddhi, Vidya, Dehu, Mohe. What I'll be getting? Bal means energy. To survive in this world, we need energy. And everything is energy and frequencies. And you know that energy cannot be created, cannot be destroyed. It's convertible. And everything is nothing but energy. It's different forms of energy. We are also part of energy, panchabhuta, our body, you know, and we are part of the universal energy. So energy is predominantly everywhere, and when you have adequate energy, you have the strength and the stamina and the courage to achieve things in life, to do things in life, to convert your thoughts into actuality. You require bala. That is power, the energy. Bala, buddhi. Buddhi is intellect, intelligence. To think coherently in a constructive way to achieve greater things in life. That is buddhi. That comes from your subconscious. The sixth sense, buddhi, sabbala, buddhi, vidya. Vidya is jnana, it's not knowledge. Knowledge, as we told earlier, is a collection of information from different sources without own experience. So vidya is a peculiar word which is not synonymous with education or knowledge, the way we understand. It is a self-evolved, means swayambhu. It comes from the within. Jnana, that is vidya. So bala, buddhi, vidya, dehu mohe. Harahu klesh vikar. Harahu means it takes away. You know, it evaporates. What will evaporate from me? Klesh and vikar. Klesh is basically tormentation. Mental tormentation, physical tormentation. You know, I may be physically ill, sick. No energy in the body. The body is filled with different kind of fears. I may be depressed. I may be irritated. I may be feeling melancholic, lonely in life. They are all klesh. Harahu, klesh and vikar. Vikar is also a very interesting word. Vikar is basically hatred, jealousy, comparisons, feeling inadequate, you know, feeling lesser than others, or too much of ego, you see, ahankara. Aham means me, the self, the pride, giving akara, or giving shape to it, making it big, you know. So ahankara, then the greed, lobha, greed, hinsa, the violence, they are all vikaras, you know. So you will be freed of all kind of klesha and vikara. Means all kind of sufferings, physical, mental sufferings and trappings, freedom and vikara. That is for different kind of mental deformities you get rid of. So the first doha, it talks about Hanuman Chalisa in a jest. Getting the grace of God through the Guru, then cleaning up the mental mirror where everything getting reflected and you are perceiving the world which is illusory in nature, understanding the illusion and the Maya, then welcoming the glory of God, His illumination, His glory, assimilating in ourselves, then knowing yourself that you know nothing and surrendering, and Sumiran, be in constant touch at a subconscious level, unconscious level, conscious level with Lord Hanuman, and subsequently you can use this process to connect to other divine energies. By doing this, we'll have power, energy, then we'll have intellect, intelligence, and we'll have wisdom and jnana, and our all mental agony and sufferings and our distorted perceptions will go away from our life, so that we'll be happy, peaceful in our life, feel complete in our life. That is how the preconditions of Hanuman Chalisa are put forward in Hanuman Chalisa book. So you must follow these guidelines and implement those guidelines, then you become eligible to read Hanuman Chalisa, and then only you will be able to reap the benefit of Hanuman Chalisa. Just by reading like parrot without understanding the meanings and all that is not going to take you anywhere. You are just wasting your time and the results are not going to come at all, because you are not following the correct path and method and the prescriptions which is given there. So please understand the doha, understand each and every word and the meaning, and then create that eligibility in you to become eligible to read Hanuman Chalisa. And you'll definitely reap the benefit. There's no doubt about it. It's 100% extremely powerful. I tell you from my own experience and from the experience of the people, those who have reaped the true benefit of Hanuman Chalisa. We'll be talking more about Hanuman Chalisa in our next videos. Thank you very much for watching my video. I am Wing Commander Santosh Sharma. I stay at Bangalore. You can contact me at +91, that is India's number, 98451 and 24158. You can also look at my website www.santoshsharma.com for more details about me. Thank you very much and Namaskar.